Hello students, myself Ganavi, assistant professor at SDM College Ujjire. In this video I am going to give an introduction to the dicarboxylic acid. So name itself says what you mean by dicarboxylic acid, where di refers to two, and you already know what are carboxylic acids. That is compounds which is having COOH groups are called as carboxylic acids. So if there are two carboxylic group in the structure, then it is called as dicarboxylic acids. So dicarboxylic acids are the carboxylic acid containing two carboxyl group, one at the each end of the saturated hydrocarbons. You can see, okay, these are the few example for dicarboxylic acids. Okay, so at the end of the each alkyl group, each carbon, there will be a two carboxylic group. In this oxalic acids, okay, it is a common name given here. In oxalic acid, there is no carbon in between the two carboxylic group, and this is the structure of malonic acid. There is a one CH2 group in between the two carboxylic group, and the two methyl group in between the two carboxylic group, that is succinic acid. Similarly, three carbons in between two carboxylic group, that is glutaric acid, and four carbons in between the two carboxylic group, that is the adipic acid. So generally there is a one formula to remember this dicarboxylic acid, that is called Ohm's gap, where O refers to oxalic acid, M refers to malonic acid, S refers to succinic, glutaric, adipic, etc. That is Ohm's gap. It is easy to remember the names of the dicarboxylic acid, I guess. Just see the slide, so you can see the IUPAC name for this. So where in oxalic acid, malonic acid, these are the common name. In IUPAC name, what you have to do is you have to count the number of carbon at the beginning, where ethane, okay, since there are two carbons, you can see this is the example, ethane, two carbons, where ethane, since it is a two carboxylic group, it becomes dioic acid. So it is ethane dioic acid. In the next, there will be a one more addition of carbon, that becomes propane dioic acid, butane dioic acid, pentane dioic acid, hexane dioic acid. Similarly, you can continue that. So this is very easy to remember the IUPAC names as well as the common names also. Okay, that is about the nomenclature, and we'll see the preparation of this dicarboxylic acids one by one. That is oxalic acid. Once again, you may saw this oxalic acid in laboratory. This is a solid, colorless solid. While doing the qualitative analysis of organic compounds, you saw this compound. Okay, now we'll see the preparation. That is, oxalic acid is usually prepared by heating sodium formate with sodium hydroxide to form the sodium oxalate. So when you treat the two molecules of sodium formate at higher temperature, around 400 degrees Celsius, where will be a formation of sodium oxalate takes place. The sodium oxalate, when it is treated with calcium hydroxide, which forms the calcium oxalate. You can see which forms the calcium oxalate. Which forms the precipitate. Once again, this calcium oxalate, when it is treated with sulfuric acid, okay, so where calcium get replaced by hydrogen, okay, will get the oxalic acid and calcium sulfate as a precipitate. When you filter that, you will get the oxalic acid. So here it will be in the form of liquid, but after the filtration by the so many process, by the purification and all, you will get the solid oxalic acid. That is about the preparation of oxalic acids. We'll see the next one, that is malonic acid. So we can prepare this malonic acid by the chloroacetic acid. There are many more methods are available. I am going to give only one preparative methods for all this dicarboxylic acid here. Okay, chloroacetic acid. When you treat this chloroacetic acid with sodium cyanide, where the cyano group is replaces the chloro group, as a result we are going to get the cyanoacetic acid. Okay, when you got the cyanoacetic acid, once again we do the hydrolysis. hydrolysis of cyano group which gives the carboxylic group. As a result, we are going to get the malonic acid. That is about the preparation of malonic acids. We'll see the preparation of succinic acid. So succinic acid, that is can be prepared from ethyl acetoacetate, that is one of the ester. This is the structure, that is ethyl acetoacetate. When you treat this ethyl acetoacetate with sodium ethoxide, since it is an active methylene compound, where the reaction takes place at this region, where the substitution of that the sodium group is going to attack here. Okay, we will get the sodium ethyl acetoacetate salt, that is. Okay, when it is treated with ethyl chloroacetate, where this sodium is replaced by this ester group, once again we will get the two ester group, one that is acyl group. When you hydrolyze this, ester groups always which produces the corresponding acid as well as alcohol. We already know that as a result. So where these produces the carboxylic group and this bond is also going to break, we are going to get the acetic acid. This converted to acetic acid, where these two bond is going to break, we are going to get the two carboxylic group. Similarly, and the byproduct is alcohol. Okay, that is about the preparation of succinic acid from ethyl acetoacetate. And the next method for the preparation of succinic acid, there is one more method I am going to explain here, that is diethyl malonate. It is also called as generally malonic ester. This is the structure of malonic ester, where diethyl, one ethyl group, another ethyl group, diethyl malonate. Okay, here that is a CH2 group, where the CH2 group reaction takes place at this CH2 group, that is sodium ethoxide, where sodium which replaces the one of the proton in the methyl active methylene group. As a result, we are going to get the salts of sodium diethyl malonate. Okay, when once again when you treat this with ethyl chloroacetate, where that sodium is replaced by acetyl group, acetate group, we are going to get the triester here. In previous method, we got two ester, one acyl group. Here it is triesters. When you do the hydrolysis, we are going to get the tricarboxylic acid. But what we need is only two carboxylic group. As a result, when you do the decarboxylation, one of the carboxylic group is going to remove, that is as a CO2. In this way, we are going to get the succinic acid. That is about the preparation of succinic acid. So in this I explained two methods. Okay, that is about the preparation of succinic acids. Thank you.